Now let's talk about admittance and how to use it in current dividers. Remember that resistance is a value that's given in ohms. Its inverse, 1 over R, is called admittance. We usually use G to represent that, and it's given in inverse ohms, or ohms to the minus 1, or 1 over ohms, and sometimes we call that mohs. Kind of see how it's ohms backwards? So admittance, right here, is 1 over the resistance. We use that in a lot of good math. For example, remember that if we have resistors in series, R1, R2, and R3, that if we want to have the total resistance over this region, R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. If we had values that were in parallel, then we had to handle that differently. One very easy way of handling that is to put admittances in parallel. If we use values G1, G2, and G3, then we can say that the entire admittance G from this point A to this point B, so G from A to B, is equal to G1 plus G2 plus G3. So it's very handy to add up resistors in parallel by treating them as admittances instead of as resistors. Now let's do a current divider using resistance. Remember that when we've got a current divider like this, we first have to combine the two of the resistors in parallel. Let's say that what I want to find is I1. So I would combine these in parallel. This would be equal to R2 times R3 over R2 plus R3. Then if I wanted to find I1, that would be equal to I0 times the resistors that it's not going through, which is this R2 times R3 over R2 plus R3, divided by all the resistors, which is R1 plus R2 R3 over R2 plus R3. That's how we handle a current divider using resistance. But if we wanted to use admittance instead, here's the way that we can do that. We don't even need to combine these into series and parallel. We're just going to be able to say that I1 is equal to I0 times the admittance that it is going through divided by G1 plus G2 plus G3. That's really a lot easier than what we did on the previous page, so I'm going to say this is a really cool way of doing current dividers. I'm going to show you how similar that is to doing voltage dividers if we have, so this is a voltage divider, if we have resistors in series, R1, R2, and R3. Let's say that I wanted to find V1. Then V1 would be equal to, this is the total voltage across here, V0 times R1 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. You can see that the form of these two equations is equivalent, except that one is handling parallel admittances, the other is handling series resistances. Now let's do an example just with numbers. Let's do a resistive current divider like this with a 1 ohm, a 2 ohm, and a 3 ohm resistor. And let's say that I want to find I1 given that I have 10 amps of current going in. That is I0. So we would first of all need to convert these two admittances. And what we would have is 1 divided by 3 mohs, 1 divided by 2 mohs, and 1 divided by 1 mohs. And again, we're looking for I1 with an I0 of 10 amps going in. So what we would say is I1 is equal to 10 amps, that's the I0 value, times the admittance that it is going through, 1 mo, divided by the sum of all of the other admittances. And that's our I1 value. That's really very simple, a whole lot simpler than doing it with resistances.